Hey everyone, welcome to Mk1 Mechanics, a yo-yo design series. My name is Mark, I run the yo-yo company Mk1 Yoyos, and today I want to talk about fingerspin designs. I had a question on the Mk1 Discord a couple weeks ago about why doesn't every yo-yo design just have a fingerspin cup, since it's a popular trick, there's lots of fun things you can do with it, and at first glance it looks like to many people that the fingerspin cup actually reduces center weight, so why not just add it to everything? Well, I am going to explore that today. So let me open up the clipping plane in FreeCAD. Alright, so this is just a monometal yo-yo design that I've been kind of working on in my spare time, and this is one that uses a 10mm long axle. I can actually add the axle from the fasteners workbench here to show you exactly what that will look like. Threaded rod, and I'm going to change this to a brass color just so it's easier to see. All right. Well, not necessarily easier to see with the clipping plane. Here we go. There. Now that's the normal fill color. Okay. So you can see there's the threaded rod there, which is the axle, and this yo-yo design has a hub to sort of like act as a housing for that. Now this yo-yo also has a weight of 62 grams, which means there's a little bit of budget to add extra material somewhere if we want to. Unless 62 is the amount of weight that you actually want. So what we can do though is we can go in here and explore and kind of see how different stuff changes it. So one of the simpler types of cups to design actually is just a flat cup. So I'm going to go ahead and do that here and just flatten this. I'm going to simplify some of the aspects of this design. There we go. All right, so you may notice quite clearly, if I just draw this line down, it is going to hit this axle right in the middle. So what we can do instead is actually pull this whole line up, right? And I think I have a constraint on here that I need to get rid of. Oh, there we go. 1.2 millimeters. So now I can slide this up and down with all those other lines moving. If I just go ahead and put this here, I can make this a little bit have a little bit less room, then we have a nice flat cup, right? And let me go ahead and add a fillet. Here we go. I'll give this a radius of 0.5. There we go. Now we have the classic flat cup style. However, this flat cup has added 4.6 grams onto the mass of the yo-yo. And of course, this is one with a 10mm long axle. It's not uncommon for a yo-yo to actually have an 8mm long axle instead. So let me go ahead and put that in here, center it. And now we can go in here, drop this to 4.1. So that's 4.1 on each side. So it'll be 8mm plus 0.2mm of clearance. And you can see that all of this has automatically adjusted. The distance between these two pieces now is 2.54, which is pretty over thick for aluminum. So it's a lot. But now, by reducing the axle length, we've gotten the weight down to 63.75. So, The weight is still almost 2 grams more. A little bit less than that. Also, the axle is going to weigh a tiny bit less just to get a flat cup. Now, let's say you want a Fingerspin cup instead. So let's do a very basic type of Fingerspin cup, which is just one with a slope here, and then a slightly more gradual slope here on this point. So we'll set some angles. Let me add a reference line here for this first angle. So let's make this 75, and we can make this angle 86, very, very shallow angle indeed. We'll connect those 2 points and add a tangent. Okay. Wow, there's not much there. Let's actually adjust this a little bit. I'm going to remove the coincident constraint and add one more line here that is just flat once again. This will give us a little bit more room to kind of control how this is working. So with those angle constraints, the main other thing here to think about is how big this middle divot is. So I'm going to give this a diameter of 12 millimeters, which should be good for landing a finger into it. So now we have a proper Fingerspin cup, like so. And the weight of this is, not too surprisingly, now 69.51 grams. Almost all of that is in this area here. I can actually create a shape to show exactly how much weight is being added there. So I'm going to make a new sketch on this plane. So on the more efficient version, which would go here, and then this would connect to there, and let me add the a distance between these. Oops. Of 1.5 for a 6061, now I just need to fill in the rest of these. So I'm gonna convert these from construction references to actual material. All right, and then I'll connect that to there, and then connect that to there. And this is going to be parallel to that. And okay, so now we have this piece of material here, right? And I am going to revolve that piece so we can see exactly what sort of thing is going on here. So this is the finger spinner. I'm going to give it the same 2.7 sort of density. And now when I calculate it, this piece of material here has a weight of 4.15 grams by itself, and there's two of them, one on each side of the yo-yo. And this is one with an 8 millimeter long axle. Many 6061 monometals have 10 or longer. So how do you actually make this use less weight. That's actually really tricky. The main way that I've seen yo-yos do this is they kind of take this angle here and make the yo-yo more shallow at this point. Another common thing to do is to use some sort of like plastic insert instead of including this in the metal. A lot of recent yo-yo factory yo-yos use that, and the checkpoint pivot, one of my favorite yo-yo factories, did that in both plastic and in aluminum to get a very, very good finger spin cup. It's also common to do this sort of finger spin area in hybrid yo-yos because with the plastic body, you're not as concerned with the sort of like the bulk of the material here because it's much less dense. And the only part that's actually aluminum is the dimple itself. So if I can also show you how the sort of like diffraction style cup works on here too. Yeah, something like that. Alright, I can remove that. And now I can look at this shape. There we go. And this, remember the previous version weighed 69 grams. Oh, I gotta remove this from the calculations. All right. It's 67.31. So is about 1.8 grams lighter than the sort of like V-shaped finger spin design. This is not nearly as good at centering, but that lower amount of weight is one of the reasons why I started using this for my cups. Well, I hope that kind of revealed what's going on in fingerspin designs a little bit more. Let me know if you have any other questions or topics that you'd like me to cover in a future video.